Welcome to Beals Science. I'm Craig Beals. It's that time of year where we take the Jeep Cannon out for a little run. And by run, I mean we take it out and we blow stuff up. Well, we're going to go big. I mean, we've gone big before, but we're going to go big time this time. We're going to make sure that we find the bowling balls that we launch out of here. We're going to bring a surveyor out into the field so that we can find them, and we're going to see just how far we can shoot these bowling balls. For the launches, we're using 16-pound bowling balls. If you've seen some of my other shoots, we're using 8 and 10-pound bowling balls. Now, why would we all of a sudden switch to 16 pounds? Great question. I contacted the world record book company to see if we could set a category for longest bowling ball launch out of a cannon. It doesn't exist. So they came back and said, okay, but only if you use a 16-pound bowling ball. So these are our test shots with a 16-pound bowling ball, which, by the way, is a little too heavy for this Jeep Cannon, as you're about to see. But that's okay. You know, that's why we built it, was to experiment. We are out here in Big Sky country. We got a whole bunch of land here, 3.5 miles worth of clear shooting ground to shoot the old bowling ball cannon. That boy's at a 45. That's right where we want to send that ball. Downrange, huh? For this shoot, it was really important for me to know how far we were shooting the ball. Last time we shot, we never did find the balls for lots of reasons. One reason, we were in an area with really big sagebrush. You couldn't see the balls, so we had to make some guesses and do some mathematical calculations to figure out how far they went. For this one, we wanted to know. So we found a different landscape, and we brought in Donovan with surveying equipment so we could do our tests with a 16-pound bowling ball. To get this 16-pound bowling ball moving out of the cannon without blowing up the entire cannon, you've got to use a special powder. So this is a cannon powder. It's slow burning, and yeah, there's a lot of flames that come out, which makes it really cool to see. It hit right on this side of that bald knob right there. It's got paint on it.
Yeah, it does.
Oh, nice. Found the ball. Look at this crew. That's the finding crew there. And if you look way over there, whoop, somewhere over there, you see them? That's where we were shooting from. Somewhere back there. That's pretty awesome that the ball has been found. Now we got to do some measuring. First shot went 2,203 feet. And that was with 1 pound of powder, a 16-pound, 2-ounce-ish bowling ball. So now we got to step it up to 1.5 pounds of powder. And then maybe go up more than that. See where we end up. So should we shoot again?
Yeah!
Yeah, of course. There it is, first shot, 2,200 feet. So we're gonna go to 1.5 pounds of powder. Should go a little further, I mean, right?
Oh, there you go.
There they go, the search crew.
Yeah. That was a good one.
Yeah, that was a good one.
Stuff that came out of it.
I found it right over there.
You found it?
Yeah.
Good job.
I found the other balls.
Shot number two went 3,002 feet. That's a long ways. I mean, 5,280 feet in a mile. So that's a pretty good shot.
How much farther than our first shot?
800
feet. 800 feet?
800 foot.
And what did you add to this powder? What was this one?
0.5 pound.
0.5 pound. There we go. They're calling for
it. Shoot again. If 1 pound is good, then 1.5 pounds is better. And if 1.5 pounds is good, then 2 pounds is even better. We've never shot 2 pounds before. So, why not? Just for a quick summary, the angle is 40 degrees, the pounds is 2 pounds of powder, and we have 16 pound, 2 ounce bowling ball. Going out that way. Here goes nothing. Okay, you gotta check this out. That last one, we don't know how far it went yet, but look at the crew. Here's the crew.
Way off there. Let me zoom in and show you. That's the scout. Okay, I'm gonna zoom back out to me.
Here I am. Now let's go all the way to where the cannon is over here.
There's the cannon. Zoom back out. Spin around right here. And go back out to the crew.
Wow.
Yeah, and we got the gavel.
Is this where it hit?
Yeah.
Yeah, feel how hard that is. Feel how hard that ground is.
Oh my gosh.
We think we got past 4,000.
You think this one's 4,000 feet?
We do. Oh. Is that what we're all going with?
Yep. Let's see.
Okay. And we're gonna hit okay. And we are gonna see our whole... Tell everybody!
What is it?
4,099!
Yeah.
Hey! All right. Woo! That's as far as I'm concerned, that's a world record. This is shot number 3. 2 pounds of powder, 16 pound bowling ball, 40 degrees, and it went 4,100 feet. One of the most common comments I've gotten on the last video shooting the cannon was that we need wadding. There's too much blow by. In other words, there's a lot of flame going around, a lot of energy going around the ball and escaping out the barrel first. Now, I will tell you that was by design in the first place because this barrel came from a scrapyard. Like, it's not a barrel made to do this. It's just a piece of pipe. Sean, who helped build this cannon, he said, while we're out here, we got to try it with the wadding. The people have spoken. So, let's try it with the wadding, Sean.
26, 2 pounds, that sounds... all the way to the 1 mark, 1 mile.
Craig, may I have half of that sheet of wadding, please?
So Sean's going big here. He's pulling out all the stops on this cannon.
Tell him, Craig, wadding seals the tube better. We get more push behind the bowling ball and we get our mile. So this cloth right here could be the difference between a non-mile and a 1 mile shot. Let's see if it works.
We've never used the wadding before. That flexed it. Oh, she rocked and rolled, man. Holy moly. There it is, fourth shot. Okay, summary from shot number 4, which was 2 pounds of powder, 26 degrees with wadding, 3,706 feet. So shot number 3 went the furthest.
So there you go. Those are the test shots with the 16 pound bowling ball. The next time we go out, we're gonna take some of the lighter bowling balls and just really see how far we can go. And we're gonna take some stuff out and we're gonna shoot at it. Maybe a car, maybe some other things, and just see what we can do with the bowling ball cannon. Now, if you have any ideas, leave them down there in the comments. Hit the subscribe, you know, all the things. But the whole reason I make all these videos is to remind you to keep on learning. Thanks for watching.